All there to do.
Yeah.
He ran and found himself inside of a large fish.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
For 3 days.
All right.
But on the third day,
yes, sir.
The fish spew him out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Right.
We find three times again when Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
And the time was drawing near to be crucified.
All right.
The Bible says that Jesus cried out. He prayed, brother.
Yes, sir.
And the sweat fell down from his forehead, yes, like drops of blood.
Yeah, yeah.
You see, when I see Jesus praying,
right.
I know I got to pray.
All right. All right.
If Jesus had to pray on three different occasions,
yeah,
and he was the great I am,
yeah,
I know I got to pray.
Yeah.
You think I take this preaching thing casually?
All right.
I didn't come down here just on a whim.
All right.
When I got the call to come, I started praying.
All right.
Seeking some direction.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if Pastor Montgomery was standing here today, he'll tell you that he prayed regularly.
All right. Yes, sir.
Seeking direction, yeah, for a second back.
All right.
But anyway, back to Peter. Peter, the third time the scripture says that Peter grieved.
He grieved.
He was getting irritated,
yes, yes,
with the process.
All right.
Because he didn't like the Lord asking him on three different occasions, why is it I've already told you that I love you
all
once?
Right.
I've told you that I love you twice.
Yeah.
Well, if God says I want to hear it three times, then three times it's got to be.
That's right.
So Peter, the scripture said that it grieved him, but he said, Lord, thou knowest everything. You know all about me, but it's something about God wanting to hear from you.
Yes. Right.
He does know everything,
yes,
about
you. Yes.
He knows all about our weaknesses.
Yeah.
He knows about our strength.
Yeah.
He knows about our past.
Yeah.
He knows about our future.
Yes, he does.
But he still wants to hear from you,
yeah,
the sheep of God.
All right.
The children of God.
Yeah.
The saints of God.
All right.
Too many times we get a little lackadaisical,
right,
and we start taking our salvation for granted.
Yeah.
Okay, we are saved.
Right.
But every once in a while, you need to tell the Lord, thank you,
yeah,
for who you are.
Yeah.
So Peter, one more time, says that, Lord, I love you.
Uh-huh.
And it tells all, it goes on to say, that Jesus said, one more time, feed my sheep.
All right.
Understand this. Pastor Montgomery is your pastor.
Yeah.
He has a calling of God.
All right.
To pastor you.
All right.
To encourage you.
All right.
To tell you the truth.
All right. All right.
And sometimes you might not want to hear the truth.
All right.
But the scripture, all right, says that if you know the truth,
all right,
then the truth will make you free.
All right.
Yes.
From what he's preaching, he's not preaching at you.
All right.
He's preaching to you.
All right.
Because God has given him a word that fits,
all right,
second best.
All right.
And all of that are in attendance.
All right.
And so you have to understand that when the sheep feeder,
all right,
is dishing it out,
all right,
he's not trying to step on your toes.
All right.
He's not trying to make you angry. From being blessed,
all right,
he wants you to prosper as God would have you to prosper. you are what you once were, but it's who you are now. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature and a new creation. For all things are passed away, and lo, all things have become new. I'm glad to know the sheep field. But more importantly, I know the supreme sheep field. With your mom, with your children, with your job, with any and everything.
Yes, sir.
And you trust God, and you learn to have a fellowship with Him.
All right.
He can give you a peace of mind that I cannot explain.
Yeah.